Okay, so good day. So this is a continuation of our chapter 1 discussion. Diba, we end at estimated liability. So this time we will discuss estimated liability, particularly the premiums, cash rebate program, cash discount coupon program, and customer loyalty program. So still the reference for this discussion is Intermediate Accounting Volume 2, 2020 edition by Conrado Valex, Jose Peralta, and Christian Aris Valex. So let's start. Okay, so course outcomes. So at the end of this topic, you're expected to know the recognition of a premium liability, know the recognition of a cash rebate program, know the recognition of a cash discount offer program, and understand the recognition and measurement of a customer loyalty program. So basically, more on recognition and measurement. So let's start with premium liability. What do you mean by premium? So premiums are articles of value such as toys, dishes, silverware, and other goods given to customer as a result of past sales or sales promotion activity. So basically, I know agi na mo ani nga mga transaction. So if you could remember, di ba, naay ka ng mga promo before sa Coca-Cola nga if makahatagtag lima ka tansan, pwede ka hatagan og baso. So kada daing baso nga gihatag sa ato in exchange sa lima ka tansan, that is premium. Also kadumdum ko sa before sa tindahan sa akong lulaglolo, di ba, namligyo sila ka ng Mighty Green, di ba, ka ng sigarilyo. So pag makatigom sila og siguro pila ka ng sudlanan sa Mighty Green, the company will give them ka ng plato in exchange sa katong murag sudlanan sa sigarilyo. Okay, so katong platong ipangatag, that is premium. So this time, how are we going to account the premiums given? Bakit? We are the entity na gahatag og premiums in exchange sa kung unsay atong ibaylo sa premium. So accordingly, when the merchandise is sold, an accounting liability for future distribution of the premium arises and should be given accounting recognition. So our concern here is the accounting liability for the future distribution of the premium. Okay, and should be given accounting recognition. So how are we going to account the distribution of the premium? Okay. So accounting for premium liability. So accounting procedures for the acquisition of premiums and recognition of the premium liability. So basically, we'll just prepare journal entries. Okay, and the transactions under the premium accounting is money siya, di ba? First is pwede na i-sale, na mag-sale dapat sale transaction because when there is a sale again, di ba, na ay accounting liability mo arise for future distribution of premiums. Kay nagbaligya man ta, so posible nga katong mga atong ipambaligya, mabalik to sa ato in exchange sa mga premiums sa atong papromo. Okay, so when premiums are purchased, so what is the entry? Okay, so when premiums are purchased, the entry is you debit premiums, nagpalit ka og premium, then you credit cash. Kung cash basis siya, pwede po sa accounts payable. Then, the premium account is classified as a asset account. That's a current asset account. So, pwede siya part of your supplies. Okay, next transaction is when premiums are distributed to customer. So, kung si customer need adto na sa imo kay magpabaylo na siya sa katong wrapper baka ha or tansan baka ha. So, how do we account for the premium distributed katong mga plato baso nga atong gi-distribute? So, we debit an expense account. So, that is premium expense. And then, we credit the premium. So, nabawasan atong supplies, atong premium. So, this is an expense account, premium expense, asset account, premium. Okay, next, at the end of the year, if premiums are still outstanding, take note, this is estimated liability. Premium liability is considered an estimated liability. So, among sa atong nahalin all throughout the years, mag-estimate lang ta, dili 100%, di ba? So, buta na to, 60% lang sa nahalin nga wrapper ang ma-redeem. Kumbaga, ang atong ilisan. Okay, so at the end of the year, if premiums are still outstanding, what if sa 60% nga atong gi-estimate nga ma-redeem, wala to na-redeem tanan ng 60%. So naay 5 outstanding, naapay balance na atong ipang-distribute nga premium. Naapay wala naka-claim, naapay wala nag-redeem. So that's why we need to account at the end of the year kay the liability account. So man isa ang balance ang wala pa na redeem nga mga premium. So yung debit premium expense account, then we credit estimated premium liability account. Okay, so aside sa entries, maghatag ko sa inyo og kaning mga formulas because sa mga problems, mga question sa problem, mga tana lang na sila pila ang liability for this year, pila ang expense for this year, pila ang nabilin nga premium or asset for this year. So for para pud paspas inyong pag-answer, especially if wala magigi na require mag journal entry, pero again, journal entries are also important, di ba? Okay, in case nagka ikakabalo unsa pag-compute but you know how to entry, possible makuha gyapon nimong answer. But kani siya for kanang paspas lang para paspas mo mag-answer. So these are the formulas. So how are we going to compute premium expense? If a pangutana, how much is the premium expense for the year? So this is the formula. So estimated premiums to be distributed, redeemed, or redeemed. So that is units niya. So mo ni katong gina-estimate na to nga 60% lang sa nahalin ang ma-redeem. Then multiply by the net cost per premium. Take note, this is net cost. What is the composition of your net cost? So the net cost is the purchase cost per premium. So mo ni itong pilay palit din mo sa katong, for example, sa baso. So that's the cost per baso. And then you have other related costs, other costs related to distribution of premium. So if mga distribution costs, mga freight and handling costs, di ba, kay gina-deliver ni mo na sa imong mga customer, for example, or sa mga retailers ni mo. So that's part of the net cost ni mo. So that's plus. Then remittance from customer. Di ba, usahay, before we give them the premium, di ba, aside sa example wrappers or tansan nga atong i-exchange sa ila, mga ipunta og kanang kwarta remittance nila, di ba? So 5 katansan plus 10 pesos asa ka mahatagan og baso. So kanang 10 pesos mo na ang remittance from the customers. So we need to deduct. So again, net cost is equal to the purchase cost per premium, other cost related to distribution of the premium, then minus the remittance from customer. Then that is your net cost. So the estimated premiums to be distributed in units times the net cost, then that is your premium expense for the year. So that is the answer for premium expense for the year. Okay. So how about premium liability? So how do we compute premium liability at the end of the year? So premium liability, so you have estimated premiums to be distributed, redeemed units. So katong gi-estimate nato nga units nga ma-redeem, then premiums distributed or redeemed, katong nahatag na nato nga mga premiums in units, minus. Then you have the remaining premiums to be distributed. So muna lang yung nabilin sa mga premiums nga atong i-distribute, wala pa na-distribute. Then multiply again by the net cost per premium. Take note, net cost siya ha, net cost. So therefore, that is your premium liability at the end of the year. Bantay lang mo sa mga problems usahay kay take note ang atong i-commit diri units ang premium ha, ang baso, ang bowl or unsa ba natong exchange. Kay usahay, di ba i-divide pa nag pila ka wrappers ana siya. Bantay lang ninyo. Then premium asset, so how do we compute the premiums or the asset account? So premium purchase. So kung pila to atong gipalit nga premiums minus ang na-redeem nga premiums. Then that is the premium and balance unit times the purchase cost lang. Take note, purchase cost lang pasabot kanilang item. Kanilang. So the purchase cost only. So times the purchase cost, then that is the premium ending balance. So if ang question sa inyo, how much is the premium or asset account at the end of the year? So this is how you compute the premium ending balance or the asset balance. Okay. So this is a sample problem. So an entity manufactures a certain product that sells at 300 per unit. So this is the selling price. So per unit is 300 pesos. A soup bowl is offered to customer on the return of 5 wrappers plus a remittance of 10 pesos. Therefore, one bowl is equal to 5 wrappers plus 10 pesos. So, man ang kumbaga condition para matayan kag bawal. So, ang bawal daw costing 50 pesos is the cost of the premium, and it is estimated that 60% of the wrappers will be redeemed. So, there is a distribution cost of premium 5 pesos. Okay. Okay, so the data for the first year concerning the premium plan are summarized below. So you have sales of 10,000 units. 10,000 units ang nahalin times 300 pesos each. So you have a sale of 3 million. Soup bowls purchase. So nagpalit kag 2,000 units of soup bowl tapos nag-sinkwinta ang isa. So that's total of 100,000. Then ang wrappers, take note, wrappers redeem. Dili bowls redeem ha. So wrappers redeem. So 4,000 ka wrappers ang na uli sa imo. Okay, so journal entry. So first, you need to record the sales. So you have 3 million sales. Let's assume that the sale is on a cash basis. Okay, so 3 million. Next transaction is record premiums purchase. Diba, we purchased 2,000 units of soup bowls at 50 pesos each. So therefore, we debit the premium asset account. We credit cash. So nagpalit ta. So on cash basis, that's 100,000. Next, record distribution of premiums. So, pila ang na-distribute nga premiums? Pila ang na-redeem nga premiums? So, di ba, ang na-redeem nga premiums is 4,000 wrappers. And ang 4,000 wrappers, di ba, every bowl, you need to exchange it for 5 wrappers. Di ba? So, 4,000 wrappers divide 5 wrappers. So, 800 ka bowl tanan ang na-redeem. So, pila ang cost anang bowl ni mo. So, that's 50 pesos man to. Plus, na kay remittance nga 10 pesos. So, 40 na lang. Okay. So, that's 800 times 40. So, that is 32,000. That is your premium expense. Tapos, di ba, pag-exchange ni mo, naka-receive ka og cash nga 10 pesos remittance from the customer. So, na-ay 10. Tapos, 800 ka bowls tanan. So, imong nadawat nga cash is 8,000. Therefore, ang total premiums nga imong nahatag, asset nga nahatag is 800 ka bowl. Tapos, ang purchase cost niya, nga 50 pesos. So, that is 40,000. Okay, di ba balance gapon siya? At the same time, di ba, by distributing the premiums, naka-incur ka og distribution cost nga 5 pesos per premium. Okay, so kaning 5 pesos per premium, so you have distribution cost 800 ka bowls times 5 per bowl. So nakay 4,000 nga premium expense from the distribution cost 4,000. Okay. Then gibayaran nimo to siya credit cash 4,000. To record the premium liability, so pilay na bilin sa 2,000, pilay na bilin sa bowl nga dapat nimo i-distribute. Okay, di ba? So 2,000 so nakay 10,000 units nga nabaligya, so 10,000 wrappers pud na siya, but you estimated that 60% lang sa wrappers ang ma-redeem. Okay, so 60% lang sa wrappers ang ma-redeem. So 10,000 wrappers times 60%, so only 6,000 wrappers imong gi-expect nga ma-redeem, estimated to be redeemed. Pila ang actual wrappers nga na-redeem? So, that is 4,000. So, minus 4,000 na ay nabilin nga to be distributed ng 2,000 wrappers. Diba? For every one ball, kinangalan ta mo exchange of 5 wrappers. So, 2,000 wrappers divide 5 wrappers. So, naapay 400 ka ball nga estimated to be distributed to the customers. So, 400 balls times 50 pesos ang cost per bowl plus 5 pesos nga distribution cost minus the remittance. So, this is the net cost. So, you have 45 pesos. So, 400 times 45 pesos, that is 18,000. Plus the liability component ni mo, so same 18,000. That is how you compute the liability component. So, pilay nabilin sa imong gi-estimate nga ma-distribute o nga wala pa na-distribute times the net cost. Okay, so if ma-prepare tag trial balance, so this is the premium, this is the asset account. This is the asset account, this is the liability account, and the expense account. Okay, so premium, Diba? Upon purchase of the soup bowl, so ang cost niya is 100,000. Based on our journal entry kagaya na, we debit 100,000. Then, pag-distribute na to, nag-distribute taog 800 ka bowls times 50, that's 40,000. So therefore, naka-balance sa imong premium asset account nga 60,000. So if the question, how much is the asset account at the end of the year, the answer is 60,000. Okay, next is the estimated premium liability. Since based on our journal entries, nalantay isa ka entry nga naay estimated premium liability na credit. So that is 18,000. Okay, for premium expense, di ba we have entries na dagan premium we debit premium expense account. So first is kanisiya, katong upon distribution of the premiums, 32,000. This is the distribution cost nga 5 pesos. Then this is the katong at the end of the year, the liability component, okay, 18,000. So you have premium expense for the whole year is 54,000. If we use the formula, for premium expense, di ba, estimated premiums to be distributed redeem in unit, so that's 10,000, we estimate that 60% ato ma-redeem. So 60% divide by 5 wrappers, so we are expecting nga na ay 1,200 ka bowls nga ma-redeem. Okay, then multiply it by net cost per premium, so that is 50 plus the distribution cost 5 minus the remittance 10, so that is 45 pesos. So 1,200 bowls times 45 pesos, that is 54,000 premium expense for the year. That is same with the T account. 54,000 based on a journal entry, 50,000. Okay. How about we compute using the formula premium liability? So the formula mao ni siya. You have estimated premiums to be distributed redeem, so that's 1,200 bowls. Pila ang na-redeem? So, di ba, 4,000 ang na-redeem, divide 5 wrappers, so 800 ka bowls ang na-redeem, na-distribute na nato. So, pila'y balance, so wala pa na-distribute, so that is 400 bowls times the net cost per premium, that is 45 pesos, then that is 18,000. So, equal siya dire, 18,000, based on the journal entry. Premium assets. The formula for premium assets ending balance, you have premium purchase, pila atong premium purchase, di ba? That's 2,000 bowls. Then, pila ang na-distribute? Diba, na-distribute is only 800. So, minus 800. Pila na bilhin sa imong premium. So, you have remaining bowls or premiums of 1,200 premiums times the purchase cost. Take note only the purchase cost. So, ang purchase cost ng 50. Therefore, the ending balance of the premium, ang nabilin nga imong premium is 60,000. That is equal to the kanyang T account na to sa premium based on the journal entries. So, pwede na siya. Depende sa given sa problem. So, if mag-journal entry mo or you use the formula. So, if quizzes, exams, purposes, mas advantage na yung formula because pas-pas siya to answer the problem. Depende po sa gi-require sa problem. Okay. Okay, so let's proceed with cash rebate program. So actually, cash rebate program, it's a variation of a premium offer. Same lang sa premium offer, which has become a commonplace. So cash register receipts, barcodes, rebate coupons, and other proof of purchase often can be mailed to the manufacturer for cash rebate. So di ba rebate, para sa sort of discount gihapon siya na pwede niyong makuha when you purchase some items. So basically, ang purpose ani is to promote sales, di ba, to increase the sales or to stimulate the sales. So accordingly, the estimated amount of the cash rebate should be recognized both as expense and estimated liability in the period of sale. So basically, we recognize an expense account and a liability account on a cash rebate program in the period of sale. If takahalin ta karon nga year, then we recognize expense and a liability account. Okay, so nilakay na ako sa expound because mas dahil naman sa subtone, di ba? So, mga example, ano, example is, nakahalin og TV, di ba? Based on the illustration, na hinahalin nga TV worth in ani nga amount, tapos, for every TV, the customer can have a rebate of 500 pesos. So, again, this is an estimated liability. So, dili 100% imong i-recognize, imong i-account. So, only based on your estimate, based on your past experiences. Okay, next, you have cash discount coupon. So actually, this is also the same with, this is also a variation of a premium offer. So accordingly, the estimated amount of cash discount should be recognized both as expense and estimated liability in the period of sale. Same with rebate program. So we recognize an expense account and a liability account in the period of sale. So pag na-sale, di ba, we recognize expense account and liability account. So, unsa yung nature sa transaction sa discount coupon? So, inani may tabo. Si manufacturer, sa iyang products na sa ginabutang dito nga, kumbaga, mo sa discounts. Okay, so, pagbaligya niya sa product ang retailers, si retailers, gibaligya kang customer. Siyempre, si customer, maan mo claim ato nga mga discount, di ba? Si customer, iyang i-claim kang retailer. Siyempre, si retailer po, manukot siya ka manufacturer. Kita-kita si manufacturer. Therefore, naatay bayron nun kang retailer. We have a liability kang retailer. So, based on katunggi pang redeem rapod sa customer sa iya. But at the point of sale, in the period of sale, once mahalin na kang customer, then we recognize. Once matransfer na to kang retailer, we recognize, di ba, expense and a liability account. Again, based on estimate. So, dili tanan atong i-recognize. So, based on our past experience, pila lang ka-percent. Then, from the time nga, magbayad na ta kang retailer, manukot ka sa retailer sa to, at usang gibayaran sa katong mga na-claim sa iya, then this is our entry. So, we debit the liability account, then we pay the retailer. So, let's proceed with the last item. So, you have customer loyalty program. What is a customer loyalty program? So, it is generally designed to reward customers for past purchases and to provide them with incentives to make further purchases. So, if the customer buys goods or services, the entity grants customer award credits, often described as points. So, basically, di ba kani siya medyo nag-apply na taan eh, di ba? So, like sa Robinsons, you have rewards cards, di ba? Sa Gaisano, Natay Suki Club, di ba? Yung anak siya. So, every time we purchase sa Robinsons or every time we purchase sa Gaisano, di ba? Mangayo silang card. Kay example, 50 pesos worth of products yung purchase, that's equivalent to 1 point. So, money siya ang application ng customer loyalty program. The question now is, unsaon pag-measure, unsaon pag-recognize ni Robinson o ni Gaisano ang katong points nga ilang gihatag sa customer. So, the measurement, according to IFRS 15, paragraph 74, provides that an entity shall allocate the transaction price to each performance obligation identified in a contract on a relative stand-alone selling price basis. So, in other words, the fair value of the consideration received with respect to the initial sale shall be allocated between the award credits and the sales based on relative stand-alone selling price. So, may tabuan eh, di ba, nagpalit ta kang Robinson, tapos si Robinson, ayang gibuhat, nag-present tag card. So, sa katay mong gibayaran nga 1,000, for example, nakay points ato nga, putang na to, 10 points. So, unsaon na to, unsaon pag-recognize, unsaon pag-measure ni Robinson ang katong sale transaction. Okay, so this is the measurement. So, this is an example. So, dapat i-allocate sa between the award credits and the sale based on relative stand-alone selling price. So, example, nipalit ta kang Robinson, ang worth sa product sa atong ipalit, atong gibayaran kang Robinson is 9 million. So, grabe nga amount purchase na to. Na grocery ta, 9 million ang worth. So, let's example lang na siya. So, standalone product, sa imong 9 million, natagan kag 10,000 points. Tapos, kanang 10,000 points ni mo, each point, pila man na siya, dapat mo equal siya o 1 million. Okay. So, nangyitabo. Standalone selling price, i-allocate na to ang 9 million based sa imong awards, credit points, pila ang na-issue nga points, and sa katong standalone product sales. So basically, the standalone product sale is 9 million. Tapos ang fair value, standalone selling price sa imong points is 1 million. This is just an example for illustration purposes. So therefore, kaning 9 million nga Atong gibayad kang Robinson, si allocate ni niya based on the fair value or standalone selling price of the product sales and the credit award points nga ilang gi-issue. So the total ani is 10 million. Then we use this watag ka ng allocation or fraction to allocate the 9 million. So that's 9 over 10, 1 over 10. So 9 over 10 times 9 million, that is 8,100,000. 9 million times 1 over 10, that's 900,000. Therefore, sa total sales nimo nga 9 million, 8,100,000 gikan sa product sales, ang 900,000 gikan sa imong standalone price of award points. Now, question, how are we going to recognize the transaction? So, the consideration allocated to the award credit is initially recognized as deferred revenue. Therefore, katong amount sa award credits, katong 900,000 is initially recognized as deferred revenue or an earned revenue and subsequently recognized as revenue when the award credits are redeemed. So, part sa imong 9 million nga sales, di ba allocated ato 900,000 sa award points. So, katong award points is initially recognized as an earned revenue and subsequently recognized as revenue when award credits are redeemed. If gamiton ni customer ang katong points to purchase other goods, di ba? If i-redeem na niya. So, the amount of revenue recognized shall be based on the number of award credits that have been redeemed relative to the total expected to be redeemed. So, may tabuan eh, ang ma-recognize nga revenue is, again, estimated lang. So, sa tanan gihatag nga points, example, 90% lang ang gi-estimate ni Robinson nga ma-redeem to siya. So, that pilang actual na redeem divided by the estimated 90% nga ma-redeem ni, estimated nga ma-redeem, so, mo lang to ang ma-recognize as sale, as revenue. So, the redemption rate is assessed each period. The changes in the total number of award credits expected to be redeemed shall be reflected in the amount of revenue in the current and future period. Therefore, pwede every year maotro ang estimate ni Robinson. Karon 90%, 95% na to next year. So, pwede siya may tabo. So, how do we account the changes? So, we account the changes on a prospective application or prospective basis. So, the changes will affect at the time of change and the future period. So, dili nang takinalan mo retroact pa. Okay, so again, prospective application. So, this is an example transaction. Kagaina, you have 9 million consideration received. Muna ang gibayad nato kang Robinson, 9 million. Then we allocate the atong gibayad based on the standalone price of the product sales and standalone price of the points nga atong na-receive. So, therefore, 81 sa products, 900,000 kang award points. So, kana 900,000, initially, we recognize this as an earned revenue. So, this is the entry. You have cash nga na-receive ni Robinson, 9 million. Then, sales, you have 8,100 from the standalone from the product sales. Then, an earned revenue from points, 900,000. Okay, at the time of sale. Okay. So, this is the assumption. So, first year estimated to redeem is 80% of total points. Therefore, na 10,000 award points, ang lang estimate ni Robinson, 8,000 lang ang ma-redeem. Sa first year points redeem, ang actual na redeem is 1,000 points. Then, first year earned revenue. So, therefore, ang ma-recognize lang ang revenue from 900,000, so yun ay sa pag-compute. So, 1,000 ang actual na redeem, pila ang estimate ni Robinson, that's 8,000 times the unearned revenue of 900,000. Therefore, for the first year, na ay na-recognize nga 112,500. So, the entry is you debit unearned. Siyempre, wala na. Na-recognize naman eh. So, sales, 112,500. So, parang zero. Okay. So, napunta gitawag na third party operates na loyalty program. So, unsay nitabo aning third party operates na loyalty program. So, inani ang nitabo sa transaction. Kita si entity. So, kita nag-offer ta og katong mga loyalty programs every time mo palit si customer, muhatag ta og points sa ila. But ang points nga atong gihatag sa ila, dili nila sa ato i-redeem. I-redeem ni customer kang third party. So, kita nakigsabot ta kang third party nga third party maghatag ko ani nga points sa akong customer pero sa imo nila i-redeem ang points. Okay, so nag-agree ta. Okay. So third party, so nani na itabo, nagbaligya ta kang customer, si customer i-redeem niya ang points kang third party. Siyempre, si third party manukot sa ato. So kita natay liability kang third party. But under this case, the measurement is still the same. Diba? I-allocate gyapon ang fair value of the consideration received with the standalone price of the product sales and the standalone price of the award points or credit points. But as to recognition, lahi siya. So recognition, revenue from points is recognized when the entity has fulfilled its obligation by granting the points. So therefore, the portion allocated to the points or revenue from points is recognized as revenue when the entity has fulfilled its obligation by granting the points. When kanus na fulfill ang obligation nato as ni entity from the time nga naghatagtag points kang customer, di ba? From the time nga na-sale, automatic naghatagtag points kang customer. So therefore, upon sale transaction or when the obligation by granting the points is fulfilled by the entity, automatic, the points allocated to the credit points or the revenue allocated to the credit points is already considered as earned revenue. So that's why the entry here is cash, sales from the product sales, standalone selling price, tapos revenue from points. So automatic, we don't recognize liability anymore because the obligation is fulfilled by granting the points. Okay, so kani siya, mo ni atong gibayad kang third party. So you have loyalty program expense, then cash. So I think that's all for this chapter.